Dave Chappelle tackled on stage during a live performance. He was assaulted by a member of the audience during a stand-up routine at the Hollywood Bowl.
Make some noise for hip-hop history.
Seeing the consequences of anti-free speech fundamentalism.
Greetings. I am Brother Spence, once again, in the Lion's Den, down here in the basement, on the month of May, the 9th, 2022, rhetorically speaking, of course. I'm down here in the Lion's Den to talk about this weird incident that took place last week, or sometime this past week, where the infamous comedian and actor Dave Chappelle, one of my favorite stand-up comics of all time and actors, gets tackled. He gets attacked and tackled on stage during his live performance, cracking jokes, doing his thing. Dave Chappelle is very militant as well. You could say political, but I know he elevates to a level of true consciousness. It goes beyond politics, and he has a divine gift, a divine spark to twist things around in a very humorous, very comical way that makes us laugh and is able to relate to the people. People like that are dangerous, the powers that be, in this whole wicked Babylon system. And the powers that should not be are attacking free speech. The things, despite the lures of this wicked Babylon system, the things that we have had in this melting pot called the United States of America, despite the basic fact that it is the core of Daughter Babylon, USA, and this whole spiritual Egypt, Yah willing, or God willing, there are still many blessings we have so far when it comes to free speech that we should still give thanks for. Thank the Most High Jah. Thank Almighty God. I'm not saying be patriotic because I am definitely not a patriot myself. Although I do believe that we should give thanks and praise for our blessings no matter where we live on the far ends of the earth. Because Babylon system is a one world beast system. America is a part of Babylon. Go back to Great Britain and England and parts of Europe, you have Mother Babylon. You have the Vatican in parts of Italy and other tyrants and corrupt governments from the seven continents from the far end of the earth. So I'm not attacking America. To you viewers out there that may be patriots, I have some good friends of mine that have been patriots. So it's not an anti-America thing. It's a world system way of thinking. The powers that should not be, I repeat, the powers that should not be, all the corrupt governments and tyranny of the globalist agenda. The globalist agenda is attacking the free speech of all people, not just so-called Americans or people of one race, although Dave Chappelle, racially speaking, is that black man, so-called African-American, that really seems to be the number one target. And that's just obvious. But all of us, beyond the boundaries of so-called race or gender or religion are under attack, our free speech. Why do we see these strange things happening? These big celebrities and actors and stand-up comics like Chris Rock, Dave Chappelle being attacked. Even Will Smith is being shamed. Was that mind control? Was it pre-scripted? Was it real? Was it fake? He asked so many questions, it becomes a distraction. So I want to meditate this afternoon. Just take a little time to meditate on the divine lyrics, speaking of free speech, the divine inspired lyrics of the rapper Killer Priest. That's right. One of my favorite rappers, Killer Priest, that's affiliated with the Wu-Tang Clan. We know his infamous track on the classic Liquid Swords album, that classic GZA album of Liquid Swords, the very last track titled Bible, and that acronym, B-I-B-L-E, the basic instruction before leaving Earth. Thanks.
Your brain is more hollow than you search for yourself.
Religion, the dark side of religion, the bad side of religion, did nothing but divide. The lures of Hasatan, or Satan, in Babylon system.
Basic destruction before leaving. Yes.
There. Stop. Let's go back one more time and listen to what Killer Priest says in his lyrics. This classic track, this classic album, it came out in the early 90s. What was it? 94, 95. Something like that. All right. Says women with wicked minds to legalize abortion. I deal with the truth and deal with the youth and teach my son as he nails on the stoop. Son, life is a pool of sin, corrupted with foolish men and women with wicked minds and little wicked signs. Legalize abortion, lie extortion with some with my wisdom. Now listen.
And punish women for making these decisions. The fundamental right to privacy.
Woe unto those that call evil good and good evil.
It's mind control. Mind control. Corruption of your thoughts, destruction of your soul.